Yeah, hello everyone. My name is Marcus Bucher. I'm also working at ATIX, as you probably have seen from my title card template already. I will tell you today something about the state of Debian support in Catello. First of all, if I say Debian support, I mean pretty much every operating system or Linux derivative that uses the Debian package manager. So Ubuntu is definitely included, and for most of the stuff I talk about, also the other Debian-like operating systems are meant. So as I already said, also working at ATIX, we had quite some talks today and yesterday already. And yeah, me personally, I worked there for I think 3 years now. And since then, I'm also coding for Catello, Foreman, and some other plugins that we provided ATIX, so stuff like the snapshot management plugin. And yeah, what I'm going to talk to you about today is basically from the good news, the bad news, and the ugly news. What are we going to do today? We're looking at what new features recently came into Catello, or from a release standpoint will come in a coming release. And yeah, as we will see, some of these pull requests take quite some time, and I'm going to elaborate a little bit about why this takes so long, and we'll also talk a little bit about what's in our development queue, and also then give you a quick summary on everything. So first of all, what recently came in? With the switch to Pulp 3 or Pulp Core, I'm not sure which one is the correct term now, it also came in that download policies now also supported for Debian repositories, basically for all repositories handled by Pulp. And yeah, we took advantage of that and added the small input field there, which you can use to set the download policy from immediate to on demand. Small word of advice, you have to choose carefully which repositories you use there, because on Debian repositories or on some of them, it might happen that not all Debian packages that were once in there will always stay in there. So they might do a cleanup there and add new versions of a specific Debian package and remove the old ones. And that might prove a little bad if you then want to on-demand sync them. Yeah, but that was probably pretty much a low-hanging fruit because it already was added by the Pulp Core team. So thanks for that. Some bigger milestone that finally got in there was applicability for Debian packages. So you're probably familiar, if you have a content host, then you can see, okay, I have a lot of content that's available on Catello, and now I want to see, can I upgrade some of that, or can I install some of that, or do I have to upgrade my content view version on my lifecycle environments to make them upgradable? So this thankfully now works. Or will work in Catello 4.3, I guess. Also some little word of advice, this only works if your host is correctly subscribed to Catello, obviously. That might prove a little difficult for some people, because not everyone likes to compile the subscription manager themselves, because unfortunately for most of, or basically all of the Debian-based operating systems, subscription manager is not part of the base repos. Given that we at ATIX, we build them regularly, because we also have a commercial product around Foreman and Catello where we have to provide them. So we talked to our boss and we finally came along that we, at least for the latest Debian stable and latest Ubuntu LTS release, we can provide them for you. So if you need them, go to https apt-ethics.de, and you can get them there. Should make it a little bit easier for people starting using Catello with Debian. So the one that took quite some time was applicability for dev packages. If you look at the pull request number, I think applicability was around 7,000, and I think we're around 9,000, or maybe we already have cracked the 10,000 already. So the next question I would hopefully like to answer is why did it take so long? The obvious and easy or cheap get out would be, time. So we have a limited number of people working on this stuff, and we also have quite some other things we work on. So Nadia already told that we're currently heavily working on Puppet plugin and the SVC Manager plugin. What we're also working on is migration from Pulp 2 to Pulp 3. And yes, we're still working on it because there are still some stuff that comes up. This also takes quite some time. And the main challenge, so to speak, especially regarding applicability, was that we need an efficient way to compare versions of various dev packages. And that proves not that easy because you cannot use the normal alphanumerical compare methods because Debian built in some specialties. One prominent thing is the tilde. So if you have a tilde if you have two Debian package versions and one has a tilde and the other one not, then the one with the tilde prepends all that have no tilde in there. And how do we want to compare them? Obviously, we want to do this in the database because there we have the data, there we have the package versions of the installed Debian packages and the package versions of the packages that are in our content view versions and our repositories. So that's a must. And if you want to have it in the database, we will have to add it in a way so Catello can add them in its database migrations. So we're stuck to Rails there, and we only have a non-super user account that does the migrations. So we cannot use something that needs super user permissions for that. That will prove a little problem later on. So as already said, the problem is we need to efficiently compare the Debian packages. If you're interested, you can look at the man page. So there is a man page for a dev version. Probably it's only available on the Debian-based systems, but you're pretty sure you can find it online somewhere. And as I already said, this requires a specific algorithm. So coming back to the title, so the good news is, one of the good news is Foreman only supports PostgreSQL. So MySQL support was dropped and SQLite as well. Catello, I think, never really supported SQLite in the first place. But that leaves us with only one system or database system that we have to support. So we could basically use database extensions or the scripting language that is usually available there. A news that would be good is that there is already a database extension for PostgreSQL that adds a new data type for Debian versions, which also adds or which then also supports indexing and sorting and all the good stuff that you're used to from your SQL-based database system. Coming back to the bad news is we need super user rights to add them to the database. So that's a big no-go currently. The only data type you actually can add as a non-super user is the composite data type, which is basically, you add an array of something that is already a base data type in PostgreSQL, that one works. And that is also how it was done in the RPM world of Catello. If you would like to know more about it, just rewatch Ian's talk from yesterday. He gave a nice talk about also this stuff. And yeah, but the problem with composite data type is you can just use the normal database sorting, which is normally done alphanumerical. And as I already said, this is unfortunately not possible with Debian. And yeah, here it where it gets ugly. Yeah, as one movie YouTube channel would say, roll credits. So how can we actually achieve them? So we have a current solution, otherwise applicability wouldn't have come in. What we actually did was to recreate this algorithm that is used to compare Debian versions within the PostgreSQL scripting language, PLPGSQL. And we add them as basically as database functions that then in turn can be used in SQL statements. It's not that nice as having a real data type for that because you always have to reference that compare functions. But I would say it works quite well. So it compares two versions from Debian packages and tells you whether it's lesser, equal, or greater. So similar to the C++ string compare method. And yeah, on the plus side, it is pretty fast, pretty much faster than Ruby on Rails, or much faster than Ruby on Rails, or doing it in Ruby on Rails, which would mean to, okay, get all the stuff from the database and then have it run in Ruby to compare them and then, yeah, do something with that. So yeah, we dodged that bullet, so to speak, for now. Yeah, but as I already said, we have no separate column type or data type for that. So that means we have no database indexing, which makes searching not that not as performant as when you have an index on your field. And what is also not that nice is that we don't have efficient sorting. Because yeah, if you want to sort now, we would basically either have to do it in Rails, Rails again, or we would have to do some kind of implementation in the PostgreSQL scripting language, which is not that nice to do. So yeah, that's our problems with the database and sorting of the versions of Debian packages. What also ties into the space problem is the Erato support for Debian. Again, if I say Debian here, in this case, especially, I also mean Ubuntu. So there are some challenges there, because one time I learned you don't have problems, you have challenges. So Debian and Ubuntu, they release security fixes. So that's a good thing. Unfortunately, they don't tie it to their specific repository, so app repository that is. And so it's not like in the Yum world where you have your errata within the metadata. And yeah, but they do have so-called Debian security advisories and Ubuntu security notices where they release, okay, we have fixed a bug there, which is tied to a specific CVE vulnerability. And we have added packages with this and that package version that will fix this problem. So again, this is not standardized. So Debian and Ubuntu use slightly different data there. And it's not part of the app repository, as I already said. And yeah, they only represent the fixed version and not really the vulnerable version. That is not that big of a problem, but it's also something that's different to Yum Errata, as far as I know. So the good news is we have already a pull request to implement it, or one pull request and two additional GitHub repositories. So our current solution is that we have created an errata service, so to speak, which consists of two components. One is the parser, which picks all the information from these Debian security advisories and Ubuntu security notices, ties them together with the state of the current security repository, and then creates some Debian errata, so to speak. And then we also have a server which then can provide those errata via REST API. And as already said, we also have a PR for that to tie it into Catello, where we then add an input field to the Deb repository, where you can add the base URL of your errata server from above here. And then it syncs the errata and integrates them like the YUM errata in Catello. So we don't actually create a new errata type, we reuse the existing Catello errata type. And yeah, this is currently heavily in development. I might have to do some more work there. Unfortunately, I didn't have the time to rebase this for some time now. But if you want to try it, the PR is out there, and this parser and the server repository are also on GitHub. You can find them at our ATX-AG account at GitHub. And if you want to try it out or test it, yeah, please do and give us feedback. Or if you have better solutions or questions, please tell them to us. So coming back to what is to come in near future, or maybe not that near future. So I already talked about Debian errata. So as you all also see, it is also in the 7,000 range of PRs. So it has took some time already. Other stuff that we're currently have in development is Debian filter and content views. So as you probably know, if you have create a content view and you add repositories to that, you can also add package filters there. And to narrow down which packages should go into the content view or into the content view version that will be created from that. And thanks to Manisha, we have a pull request for that. I think it will still take some more time because it still needs some work regarding PULP3 there. Unfortunately, the first implementation will be without the version filter. So in the first draft, you will not be able to filter by version, but only by a package name and package architecture. Maybe we can add the version filter now that we have at least some procedure of comparing Debian versions, but that will probably be another pull request. Also tying in with the whole version compare stuff is a pull request I added recently. You might know if you look at the REST API that Catello provides on the tab at packages, in this case, the Debian packages, or currently not the Debian packages, you cannot restrict to the latest file version or latest package version. So I did add a PR for that, but I'm currently unsure whether it is really ready to be merged, because as I already said, we're currently lacking the sorting ability for Debian versions because we don't have a specific a data type for that in the database. So sorting the Debian versions is not that efficient. And that's also the case with this PR. So if you want, you can have a look at it or even try it out and see how it works. I didn't do that much efficiency tests or performance tests right now, but it's at least something if you really, really need it. Something else that recently kind of came in, as I already said, we are still working on PULP 2-3 migrations. And what came up during one of our tests recently was that you can migrate Debian repositories or write But unfortunately, after they are migrated, they are not synced. They are not signed. So if you have used Debian repositories, you probably know that your Debian host or your Ubuntu host usually doesn't like repositories that don't have signed metadata. So the reason for that is that the signing method or signing process has changed from part 2 to part 3, and there is no automatic migration of that one. I think I have an article on Discourse where I describe how to create the signing service stuff for PULP 3, for PULP Debian. This is basically the same that you have to do when doing the migration. Unfortunately, if the migration takes place, the migration itself doesn't know that it has to that has to link this new signing service that you just created manually with the pack with the repository that you just migrated. So what I did was that I added a new setting in the migration plan, or a new field in the migration plan, where you can specify the name of the signing service that should be used. Unfortunately, I didn't have time yet to create a Catello pull request for that, but yeah, I hope that I will have time to do this soon so we can get in. So PULP thankfully already merged this pull request, but the Catello side is still has to be done. That's mainly what I want to talk to you about. Let's do a quick summary there. So PULP 3 support, it's in there since Catello 3.18, obviously, because 3.18 started to use PULP 3 and also will be used to do the migration from PULP 2 to PULP 3. PULP migration associating signing servers is what I just told you. So if I come around to do or to create the pull request, it will probably be added in one of the 3.18x releases, assuming there will be some more of them, because after 3.18, PULP 2 will not be available anymore. So if it will be done, it has to be done there. Applicability for dev packages to content hosts. It was recently merged, so it will be in 4.3 Catello, hopefully, as well will the download policy. Debian RAD support, to be defined, as we're still working on the pull requests. Same applies to content view filters. And that's basically the state of the Debian support or Debian package system support. And so thank you for listening to me. If you have any questions, please ask them now. If you want to ask them later or they come to you later, you can reach me on GitHub, Discourse, also in the metrics chat. And you can also write me an email, but you will reach me some way or another. And that's all I have to say today. Thank you.
Thank you, Marcus. Just for the sake of the recording, Quirin just posted there in the chat that just one more word of caution: the smart proxy sync for Debian content to a PULP 3 proxy only works starting with Catello 4.2.1, and I just wanted to add that in case anybody needs to know that and they might miss it in the future. Has anyone any questions for Marcus?
Had a question for Marcus myself. This is Partha.
Hey, Partha.
So you mentioned that the composite data types, they're not very amenable to, like with composite data types, you're resorting to string compare, is that correct? Is that the reason you said you move to stored procedures?
So if you add a composite type, it's usually, we have an array of tuples or something like that, which is basically the same system that is used for RPM. Uh-huh. And if it does a sort in the database. It usually does this. So if you have an array, then it compares the first element of the array with the usual string compare, I guess, so alphanumerically. And yeah, it does that for all the little elements of that.
That doesn't work for Debian, basically. Is it?
Yes, that's exactly. Because as I said, you have some special cases, for example, with the tilde. So if you have the tilde in one of your package versions, this package version prepends all the other versions that have the same prefix.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And yeah, there's no way we could find to do this. We could basically have added the same system where we all also split the version and the release and the epoch into all these elements, but right. it wouldn't really help us because we also would have to do the would have to use our functions for that. So
if I remember, Pulp2 had something called a sortable version that it would just take like RPM with all these different things and make it one uniform string so that you could just easily sort it like a string. If you guys thought about something like that, I don't know if it'll work in your situation.
Yeah, I think we looked at that as well, but we didn't really find a good way to implement that. So,
okay, thank you.
Thanks, Andrew, for adding a very copy-pastable link. any further questions for Marcus?
I mean, so you ended up basically doing a sort of procedure in order to make it faster, or is this sentiment done as far as...
Super hard to hear you, Andrew. Can you turn up your mic a little bit?
I was just wondering, you couldn't actually do a stored procedure as far as making that faster, or that just didn't seem to work for you?
For the version compare in database? Mm-hmm. Yeah, basically create a set of database functions, so to speak. So if you want to do a compare, then you just do a select and then say where, and then you have to say, okay, that version compare, brackets, version 1, version 2. And then you can say, okay, this has to be smaller or bigger than 1 or equal 0 if you want to have the same. So it doesn't really make SQL instructions easier using just this this function. But yeah, it is one way to do it, at least.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, and thank you for your questions. Marcus, thank you very much for this update. I know that there's many in the community that will be happy to hear about this. And I will be, just if there are any questions later on, as we're kind of close for time now, just please post to our community discourse, and I'm sure Marcus will be happy to answer them. And I'll just stop the recording now. Thanks again.
Thanks.